My name is Kate Simpson and I'm the practice manager of the Sugarloaf Animal Hospital. The main way that we've been able to reduce our electricity usage is behavioural change. We used some signs on our light switches that were fluorescent and do you need me on, that sort of thing. The online monitoring system was a great help.
My name's Chris Hicks. I'm the CEO of Newcastle University Sport and we're the proud operators of the Forum Sports and Aquatic Centre here at the University of Newcastle. The project we undertook was to replace some very inefficient and unreliable metal halide lights in the two sports halls here at the Forum Sports and Aquatic Centre. We replaced 12 lights in the Ocmedia Court and 16 lights in the Stadium Court with energy efficient LED lights.
Hi, I'm Laura. I'm the Corporate Services and Sustainability Coordinator at Compass Housing Services. We've implemented sensor lighting, individual light switches, as well as energy efficient fluoros. We've also installed a synchronised switch that links all of our non-essential energy, which is then switched off overnight or on the weekends.
My name's Neil Green from Ultraflow and I'm the factory manager. Energy efficiency has changed the way we've done business by changing our start times. That allows us to keep our peak capacity charge outside of the peak hours and smooth out our usage so that we don't have a large peak capacity.
My name is Bruce Woods. I'm the owner operator of Bushrangers Bar and Brasserie at Largs in the Maitland local government area. The energy saving projects that we initiated, firstly led by the LED lights, secondly energy saving globes outside for nighttime lighting, the car park with LED floodlights, which made a significant difference there, followed by PVC curtains into the cool room, which give us a saving of something like $200 a month and paid for the $980 output very, very quickly. Our heating for wintertime is a derivative of the seal units, recirculating the heat throughout the hotel, and in summertime, exhausting that heat to atmosphere.
The real benefits that we saw was a reduction in our electricity bill. We have managed to save, just in the first 6 months, by behaviour change, 25% of our electricity bill. Caring for the environment was the biggie for us, and the added bonus of reducing our costs and saving money has enabled us to be able to spend that money on further reducing our footprint, so LED lighting and Voltaic cells and things like that, which is really cool.
But as soon as the lights had been installed, we were seeing a reduction of 70% in our power usage for the lights, and that has led to an overall decrease in our energy usage across the facility of approximately 10%.
After our initial strategies were implemented, we were able to see a reduction in consumption over the 12-month period when we compared year on year.
Benefits we saw where our peak capacity charge reduced from around $1,200 to around $800. We had better efficiency from our power factor correction unit and general costs were down.
Benefits were achieved at the time of implementation, particularly with lighting. The PVC curtains reduced the cost by $200 a month, so the total cost of $980 was quickly repayable, and our overall energy costs dropped by 25%.
The lessons that I would share with people who wanting to reduce their electricity consumption, the biggest lesson, the simplest lesson that I could put out there is turn stuff off.
One of the lessons I would share with other businesses is to start the process by gaining an understanding of the energy usage of your business. If you're able to understand the energy usage, then you can start a process of identifying certain projects that might save you in the long run.
I do believe other organisations can benefit from energy efficiency projects, learning how to work smarter and achieving cost savings through energy efficiency projects.
My advice to other businesses is to hire a consultant to negotiate pricing levels with your energy providers. However, at the end of the day, you should follow through, and most probably there'll be a better price with the help of that consultant. So there is real savings in reducing your energy costs per kilowatt hour.
Single most important thing a business can do is to monitor their energy usage by using something like WebGraphs that allows you to look at your peak capacity charge and your other network charges, and where you can make some easy savings.